Hi students, in today's session I'm going to discuss excellent trick to draw resonance structures. In my previous video I discussed about the resonance and when resonance takes place and what are the main requirement for a particular molecule to show the resonance. I discussed there. Now in this session I'm going to discuss about the trick to draw resonance structures. And here see, take phenol, to this phenol how many resonance structures are possible. To know this, first you should know how to draw the resonance structures. See here, in my previous video I discussed pi bond, sigma and lone pair are in conjugation, so this molecule shows the resonance. So what happens here is, this lone pair shifts here. When lone pair shifts, here bond will form, and this bonded electron shifts, pi electron shifts to this carbon. Then we get double-headed arrow represents resonance. When these two electrons shifts here, we get one bond extra, and here oxygen is there, H, and still one lone pair is left. And whenever oxygen, more electronegative atoms like oxygen, when their octet is completed by donating one of the lone pair, they get a positive charge. And whenever these two electrons shifts here, this carbon gets negative charge. And these two bonds are as it is, you have to write. Next, if you observe carefully, this pi bond, sigma and negative charge, these three are in resonance. Means one of the condition for this is double bond, sigma, lone pair, or pi bond, sigma and negative charge. These are the conditions for resonance to take place. I discussed in my previous video, right? And here what happens is, this electron pair shifts here, this electron pair shifts here. Then we get, when this shifts here, bond, this shift here, negative charge, and here bond as it is, and double bond, O, H, lone pair, and one positive charge, right? Again, this negative charge shifts here, this pi bond shifts, then we get bond, when it shifts bond, when it shifts negative charge, and double bond oxygen H, and here positive charge lone pair. Next, this negative charge shifts here, these two electrons shifts here, then we get and oxygen with lone pair, again it gets its lone pair. Total how many RS are possible, students? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 resonating structures are possible for phenol. Clear? Now let us see one more structure. Cyclopentadienyl anion. To this, how many RS are possible? Just write, these two electron shifts, these two electron shifts, right? Then this is as it is. When these two shifts, we get bond. When these two electron shifts, we get negative charge. Again, see here, the condition is negative charge, sigma and pi bond. These three are in resonance, right? Again, negative charge, sigma, pi bond is in resonance. Then this shifts here, these two shifts here. We get negative charge, sigma, pi bond is in resonance. Then this shifts here, these two electrons shifts. Then we get negative charge, sigma, pi bond. Then again these two electrons shifts, these two electrons shifts. We can get negative charge, sigma, pi bond. And how many structures are possible? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. But sixth structure is similar to that of the first structure. These two are same. So total of 5 RS are possible to the cyclopentadienyl anion. You may get the doubt here. See, why ma'am, why first structure and fifth structure you are not taking as a similar structure in case of phenol, but you are taking in case of this one? Because here both are same, but if you observe here, the bonds are present. Suppose if you give numbering in this side, the bonds are present between 1 and 6th, but in this case it is present between 1 and 2. But in this case, if you give the numbering in this direction, the bonds are present in the same places. That's why these two are same, but these two are not same. I hope you like this video. Please give like to this and subscribe my channel, share with your friends and comment me if you have any doubts on this particular topics. I'll upload the videos and thanks for watching my channel.